Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Fire Emblem Sacred Stones. This is yet another episode with a special guest. This, from Patreon. This is David. Please say hello.
Hello.
but yes, doing another guest for this series because I felt like it. I know I said I probably wasn't, but that's what we're gonna do. And this is a retry of the last chapter. I'm assuming you guys saw it because you should watch things in order. But we're gonna try a new strategy this time. We are going to go this direction. Everyone is gonna go this direction, as opposed to before when I split the army up. But the plan is for everyone to go this direction. And now that I'm looking, I think I see what I'm gonna do. David, unlike the other people who have been on my things before, I've actually talked to them before and know who they are, kind of. I don't know much about you. Tell me about yourself. What are you into?
Well, I started watching your videos with the Black Nuzlocke.
Okay.
I thought it was the greatest thing we've ever seen, because this was back when I was younger. I didn't realize that editing was a thing.
And you didn't realize it was actually really crappy.
I wouldn't say it was bad, but it was pretty bad. With whole Goma situation at the end.
Oh yeah.
But other than that, into things like League of Legends, World of Warcraft, and
okay.
pretty big nerd. I play Pokemon.
Mm-hmm. All right. You know. Yeah, I noticed in the chat you were talking about League of Legends a lot. Yeah, I had nothing to add to that.
That's all right. It's not really for everyone.
Yep. But yeah, we saw this cutscene. But yeah, we're
blabbering to each other.
Yeah. And yeah, don't be afraid to say anything. Like I'm used to just trying to fill every bit of silence with me talking, because that's how narration should sound. But if you need to say something, interrupt me and just say it.
So. All right. is how different is Sacred Stones from Awakening? Because I haven't played this one.
Awakening. Let's see. Awakening, I feel like I took what Sacred Stones did and expanded on all of it. Like, Sacred Stones was the first one, at least internationally, to have a world map where you actually choose the different levels you go to, and branching promotion paths for units. Every game that came out before that, and a couple after, such as Path of Radiance, Radiant Dawn, they're very linear. They're just, you play one level, you beat it, then you're in the next level, then you play that, and so on and so forth. And the other big thing Awakening added was the child system, where when two people support each other and they become married, they have a child. In this, right. all it affects is status boosts when they're standing next to each other, and it affects the ending credits. Like, it's just, oh, these guys fell in love, and blah, 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 blah. We're all happily ever after, and stuff like that.
Alright, well, that's, seems like some, pretty good improvements they made then.
Yep.
I enjoyed the child system.
Oh yeah, I like that too. See, I'm just trying to think here.
That's alright.
One thing I've said this before in this playthrough, but I am a sucker for sprites. I prefer these graphics over Awakenings, and I might be weird for that. But that's just me. I don't know what kind of graphics you prefer, but Let's say, like, for example, here's my biggest example I always give people. I prefer the graphics of Super Mario World over Mario 64.
See, I like the graphics of Black and White versus X and Y.
I agree entirely. Yep, I would agree with you on that.
It's not that I don't like the 3D. 3D's great and all,
right.
But it's not really Pokemon anymore without having flat. The animated images were cool, but I don't know, I just preferred the sprites.
Yep, I know what you mean.
Made everything look more, I don't know the word for it, but it's what I enjoyed about it.
Yep, I know what you mean. Like, for example, 3D technically requires more, like, what's the word? Like, more power from the system, so it's harder to run. So one could argue that it's objectively better, but in my opinion, it's all art style and what you prefer.
I definitely agree with that one.
Yeah. So, I mean, and I have nothing... I also say that I have nothing against X and Y's graphics. For 3D, I feel like they did a good job. I just... It's,
yeah,
it's
for the first 3D one... Like, for the first 3D game in the series, I thought they were pretty good.
Yeah. And then Vanessa... I mean, Tana, whatever her name is in trouble. She looks like she's safe if she stands right here. Right? Yeah, okay.
Why does...
What's that?
Why can Dazzler move through water as a berserker?
Because berserkers are the promotion of the pirate class, which is what these guys are right here. And that's their ability. They can walk on water, but only one space at a time. And this guy is going to be problematic, this cavalier coming from behind. Okay, someone's going to have to take care of him.
Did you leave anyone behind to take care of the people who start to come after you?
No, I currently have just a wall forming on this side. Mm-hmm. See, I think I'll figure it out, I think.
As long as they're not close enough to hit you yet.
What's that?
As long as they're not close enough to hit you from behind yet.
Yes. So this might be the wrong decision, what I'm doing right now, but... what I did last time didn't work, so I'm trying something else. And... Mm-hmm. Okay. Seth leveled up in the first attempt, and that was his level this time. I feel like they're both pretty good.
I'm surprised he was able to two-hit that one.
I'm not surprised. I mean...
Like, the double attack thing.
Oh. I mean, I guess pirates are pretty slow. Mm-hmm. So... And he is an evolved unit. He wasn't... Right. It was the cavaliers on this side he wasn't doubling, because they're, I don't know, pretty similar to his class. So...
So that's what, a paladin?
Paladin, yeah, that's the upgraded form of Cavalier. So, and yeah, it doesn't look like they're going to be able to jump behind. And Odazzo should be able to double this guy. Yep, because steel weapons are a lot heavier. But yeah.
I'm liking Dazzle so far.
Yeah, I might actually consider using him.
I'm not usually a fan of the Berserkers. Whenever I would play Awakening, I would get, you know, the Vake or Donald, or I would never make them Berserker.
Okay.
Because they're just too. I didn't trust their accuracy.
Yeah, I know what you mean. They have their ups and downs, and it looks like Seth is in trouble. That's okay. We have a bunch of healers. I just didn't have them move directly behind them, so they couldn't be attacked with a hand axe.
Right.
And you're really going for loot. All right, that's fine. You're probably gonna miss and then die. Haha. Apparently that was the highest amount of damage you can do. And pointless critical hit, because why not?
It always happens when you don't really need it. Then get one when you want it.
No. The only times I feel like that it could ever help are like if you're using a killing weapon and specifically trying to get a critical because of it. And all right,
I was actually playing Fire Emblem and I was in the desert area when you find the cleric. I was thinking, the war monk, I think his name is.
Libra? That level?
Yeah, Libra.
Yeah.
I was one of the archers. Crit Crom down to 1 HP.
Oh.
And the only way he was going to survive was if I attacked the guy the next turn and got a crit.
Mm-hmm.
Because the archer was in range because I was next to a wall.
Okay.
So I couldn't move far away. So I have please get a crit, Crom. What is he? He doesn't crit. He dies. So I have to restart the entire chapter. All because I even have put a killing weapon on him. I've specifically moved someone to get a killing weapon on him.
Wow. What was the percent chance for the critical? Do you remember?
55?
Okay, yeah. So it was a coin flip, basically. But,
It was. I was just very... just not happy.
Yeah, I can see that.
He didn't listen to me.
Mm-hmm. Alright, you're gonna... Is that risky? I wanted to heal him after he walks forward, but that might not be possible. Mend him, Boulder, please.
Was Seth able to one-shot that guy?
With a steel lance, yes. That might be dangerous to put on him, though, because he may get... he's not going to be able to double anyone who attacks him, but everyone's going to attack him at long range if they do that. And this mercenary can't even reach him, so we will just do with the steel lance.
Right.
Yay. Okay, I'm actually feeling good so far about this. So far. That's before all the reinforcements have joined.
We're looking good so far.
What's that?
We're looking good so far.
Yes, it would appear so.
The only thing I'm worried about is them gargoyles coming up.
Yeah, they can't reach us this turn, so I'm not worried about them, at least not yet. Yeah. I should probably try to be a couple steps ahead of them, but I can't think of anything right now. And Dazzle can't double this guy. Can Dusel? Probably. Dusel's pretty good. Yes, he can.
Is Dusel a peddler paladin?
Dusel is a great knight, Frederick is from Awakening. Great knight is not... Yeah, it's a branching path for either a cavalier or a knight. This was the first game that introduced it. It was never a direct evolution, so to speak, of another class. Like, paladin was originally what immediately cavaliers promote to, and generals are what knights promote to. But yeah, so great knight was just introduced as a branching path for either of them.
General is the big tank, right?
The really big knight, yes.
Right, okay. And I had to remember, I haven't played in a while.
Yeah, not a problem. Dazzle, I feel like he's in trouble no matter where he goes. Oh, he can walk on water. Stand here in this water.
Just stand here. You'll be fine.
Yeah, trust me. I'm a war expert.
Yeah, don't worry, there's no sharks, I swear.
Yeah, we're too close to the shore, I guess. Loot should be able to handle all these gargoyles. What I'm worried about is her surviving.
Right.
I'm going to leave everyone else where they are.
What you could do is you could, since you do have three healers, you could set her off with a healer. And then if she does take too much damage, heal her afterward.
I feel like she'll die, but with full health, because she has such low defense. I feel like just a stab from all of them would be more than
I forgot. I forgot those guys used weapons, not magic.
Oh, yeah. The shaman I'm not worried about over there.
Yeah. But,
okay, I'm just going to leave everyone else where they are. Hopefully that's not a terrible idea.
Everything's going to work out fine.
Oh, well. He's not going to do much damage.
Yeah, he's weak. He doesn't know how to play. He doesn't train his units correctly.
No. By he, I guess we mean the Emperor Vigard? Or do we mean... I don't know.
I don't know. Are all these guys their own unit entities? Or are they controlled by the generals? Or?
Good question. I don't know. I know that the regular people we're fighting are soldiers of Grotto, whereas the monsters in this level were summoned by Riev. Or at least being controlled by him. I don't know if he was the one who specifically summoned them, but...
Is Riev the creepy-looking dude?
The creepy old guy that appeared a couple of times. Oh, and he's shooting La Rachel. Oh no, I might lose La Rachel.
No, not La Rachel. The one who I didn't know you had.
Yeah, I don't really care about... I don't care about her at all. But she can be useful in this level, so... Alright, now we're in trouble. Ross, can you help? No, you will die.
That's unfortunate. I really liked Ross.
Yes. Tana, can you help? God, no. Okay, these gargoyles are hard.
Well, they're made of stone.
I guess they are. I guess they must be weak to magic, because loot did fine on the first attempt. Yeah. Crap. Ephraim, you can't even reach them except with a javelin. That won't even kill him. Oh, boy.
I was thinking, loot going to kill one in one hit?
Yes, she'll kill him in one turn, yes.
Oh, because I was thinking if you could just get him down real low, you could finish it off with Ross or Tana.
I'm thinking I'm going to do that with the one that Ephraim can hit. I'm going to do this. I'm going to attack this one with loot, the one with the horse slayer, because that one's good against a lot of people. So I don't want to risk that one hitting someone.
Right, you want to make sure you keep everyone alive.
Yes, as many people as possible at least.
Hopefully. But I'm sure it'll be fine.
Alright, Tana can only do 4 to this guy. Ephraim, do this, because this is the best we got. Throw a javelin at this guy. Please hit both times. Thank you. Oh, 4! Okay, good.
Yeah,
Tana
that should,
can
leave, leave enough for... Yeah.
Just... 81. If she misses, she's basically dead, because then the other one's going to finish her off.
Right.
And this one will still be alive. Oh, Archer! Can you help at all?
We do have Archer.
Can you hurt this guy? Oh, he has a higher percent accuracy on this guy. And he won't die. You know, that's the backup. Atana I actually plan to use, so she needs more experience. Right. So Atana try first. Okay, good.
I wasn't worried.
You were worried, okay.
Much.
But yeah, can I reach the gargoyle to see how much he can do? No. That guy will kill Archer if I attack him and then he attacks me back the next turn. So, Ross, what can you do to this guy? 12! 12 plus 4, that's not enough.
Is loot in danger right there from that gargoyle?
Yeah, but she can survive at least one hit, so I'm not worried. Okay. I am worried about Ross, though. I'm actually worried about the shaman now attacking Ross.
Can you move him past the other person there? Or?
Yes, but then he'll be on this side with all these all these evil people.
Oh, right. I don't want that. That would be bad.
I think I have an idea. I need to take care of this side first. Hold on. LaRachel, Dussel, Seth. I wish I had one more bulky unit I could put. Oh, wait! Dazzle! How does Dazzle fare against magic? They'll lose 6 to him? I don't know how much I like that. I didn't give him a hand axe, did I? Great. If I stood here, would my plan still work? Da-da-da-da. No, there'd
depends
be a hole,
on what your plan is.
I'm trying to make a diagonal wall. It would block both down here and this plank.
Right.
Putting Dazzle here would work, but I wouldn't attack anyone that turn with him, and I kind of wanted to attack someone with him, but maybe I can't. Maybe it's not worth it.
Mm-hmm.
Are
they going to go after your healer over there? Those, what are they, shaman mages?
This guy? The shaman? I'm more worried about the archers, to be honest.
Right above, so if you go up a couple spaces, those guys.
Yeah, that's why, I want to put someone on this plank, so they can block this area off.
Yeah.
I can see Archer dying right now. Ross or Archer dying this turn. Neither would be the end of the world, but still unfortunate. Yeah. Natasha is not in danger from the gargoyle, so I'm not worried about her. She can take a magic attack from the shaman if she had to.
Right.
Alright, okay, you gotta think this through. Ford, can you help at all? No, there's no one in danger. There's no one who can hurt enough. Someone suggested in the last episode in the comments that I should just not bring a bunch of these units because they're more trouble than they're worth. I agree with you to an extent. The problem is I want to use this arena with those units. Maybe that's not worth it.
And to use the arena, you gotta bring them with you.
Right, that's at least the logic I was using with bringing them along. Because, I mean, to be honest, if I lose again, I guess I'll try just bringing, say, E-Frame, Seth, Dussel, Dazzle, loot, and maybe the healers.
Yes.
I feel like that would be a little easier to manage.
I could see that happening, but I don't know. I don't want you to lose this one.
Right.
Not good.
I think I can see how
he'll
one-shot
that guy.
No, that won't block the wall. No, my only chance is to put someone in this slot. Who do I think should go in each slot? Dussel's got 9 resistance, 17 defense, 41 HP. Seth's got almost all the same stuff, except worse. Yeah, Seth's the worst. Then we got Dazzle, really bad defense and resistance, but he has the most HP. Okay, so right. Seth is the worst of the bunch, so he's going to stay back. He will stay here and attack this archer. And then Dussel. Okay, the weird thing is I want to heal him, except if I heal him, that healer will be in danger from the archer over here. I got a short bow, hooray.
You got a short bow for those archers you have, right?
Yeah, but yeah, like this archer, that archer can't reach us, and then this shaman here. LaRachel, should I just not care? Should I just leave her right there and not care if she dies? She could be bait. Or should I move her back and heal, use Mulder to heal Seth right now?
Do you think she's going to be useful?
I don't know.
In the upcoming?
She could be. That's the problem. She could. Right, oh, wait! Wait a minute. Natasha can heal Dazzler. Yeah, Natasha can heal Dazzler. Is there any way to see? She has 12 resistance. I think she can survive some magic attacks. So Dazzler, go here. We're good. I know what I'm doing.
Yeah, she has enough HP plus resistance.
Yes, and I did give her the angelic robe at one point, which boosted her HP by 7. So, okay. Now that that's out of the way, Roz is still in trouble. Let's move him back here. And then the shaman still can hit him. This guy no longer can, though. So then I just put Archer here, and then Archer will probably get attacked by the shaman.
Mm-hmm.
Or the shaman will attack Ross. One or the other. But I don't think he can kill him in one turn. Actually, you know what? They might go for Tana, now that I'm looking at this.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy. Well, great. If Tana dies, I'm out a flyer for the rest of the game. Oh, wait, no, that's not true. There's one more we get later, but she's not that good, in my opinion. Okay, let's heal Seth. What's Mulder? Mulder's... Oh, I got an idea. Heal with Mulder, and then I'm going to rescue him with Ford. Because Ford's not doing anything.
I never remember the rescue option. Never remember that option.
Yeah, that was taken away from Awakening and replaced in favor of the...
Pair function?
The pair-up function. And then drop him here, and he's safe.
Right.
Sweet. And then LaRachel, she's not in danger. And then Dussel's the only one who can move right now. She'd throw a hand axe at this guy. Not worth it. Just keep your iron axe equipped. Alright, let's see what happens. Going for... okay, they're going for Dazzler this turn. Well, he's not going to kill this guy, so...
Right, and he missed.
That's it's fine that he missed, because now that spot is not open for another unit to stand there.
Fair enough.
Okay. Ugh. That's going to do a lot! Oh my god!
Why does that do so
critical
much?
Critical hit. Okay. Dazzler, this might not have been an ideal time for critical hit, because now another unit can take that spot. They're going for loot? Okay.
Why did that spider do so much damage?
I don't know. Maybe they're really, really strong? I didn't think they were that strong.
Hmm.
And I don't know why they're going
for loot. I'm just thinking.
What's that? You think the other spider?
Dazzler, why are you getting two-shot by this guy, please? Please don't die.
This guy's a Lance Reaver. That's the wrong weapon to use against me right now. Okay.
Maybe that's all he could afford.
Maybe. Oh, boy. All right, we are in trouble. Dazzler's the most in trouble, but he has Natasha right there. She can heal him all day. Although, he's looking in trouble. He's looking to be in trouble right now.
Yeah.
Because now he's going to attack by one more mage. That's only 6. Okay, he's good. After that, there's no more spots for them to occupy, so he's good.
He did what he was supposed to do.
Yep. And this guy's going for Dussel. Ha, he's desperate. maybe I should have equipped the hand axe now that I'm looking at it. Oh, well, that's fine. Not a huge deal. All right, and this guy's
going
for...
You know what they say, hindsight's always 20/20.
Yep, but I was thinking the hand axe is low accuracy, so... But I should have thought, they're not even going to attack anybody. Yep, Ross, okay. Oh, it's a one-shot!
No!
Well, crap, Ross is dead. Bye, Ross!
No, I liked Ross.
Oh!
I liked his character.
Yeah, I like Ross, too. Oh.
Unfortunate.
Well...
Oh, dang it, Ross, why'd you have to suck?
Well, alright, now let's take a look at this. We gotta kill that shaman. I'm looking at Tana right now, because she's good against magic units. Yes, she can do this. So maybe she hits both of these 90% chances.
Is she good against magic because she's a Pegasus Knight, or
Pegasus Knights have really high resistance.
Okay.
So, it's not like it's super effective or anything. They're just typically good for resisting their attacks.
Right, I didn't think it had, like, some special quality.
Oh, no, yeah. I don't know, they're like the one physical unit that they decided to give good resistance.
Mm-hmm.
Ephraim, you need to come back over here and help us. He can't reach anyone to attack right now, so that's kind of a problem.
Mind Ephraim, you're slacking.
Alright, first things first. Hold on. Actually, before I do that, can I attack anyone and survive? Yes! Yes. Start by killing this guy. You'll survive this, because you'll kill him. There. Now I'll heal you.
Oh.
Okay. And then... Should... Man... This, I don't think this will heal him all the way. Because he has a lot of HP to heal.
Yeah.
No, that did not. Alright, we may need to heal him again with Mulder. Is Mulder safe standing like there?
Like Berserkers should get more... Berserkers should get more accuracy when their health drops low.
Oh, that'd be interesting.
The lower their health gets, the more accuracy they get. Because, you know, they're focusing more on the battle now.
That makes sense.
I don't know, I like the Berserker's design.
Oh, yeah.
Not their practicality as much.
Yep, I know what you mean. These guys really need ranged weapons. Does anyone have a javelin they can borrow?
I thought Seth had a javelin.
No. Ephraim has the javelin. Oh, wait, can he reach Seth? No, he can't. Dang it. Oh, wait, you can reach Ford.
And then Ford can reach Seth.
Ford's going to be in danger if I leave him here. He'll be needed for a mage and an archer. Possibly two mages if they decided to go that route. Just so I know, how much can they do to him? 12 and 9. That's actually not enough to kill him. So he's fine.
Right. What about that archer, though? Plus the archer.
But there's only two spots for them to stand where they can hit him. And right. Seth... has horrible accuracy. I'm worried about this shaman. He does the most damage, I feel like. Try to kill him. And I may need to heal Seth, just to be on the safe side. Although, Dalzo's the one they're really hammering. So maybe I should heal him again. I don't know. It's hard to say, because anyone who stands in these spots is in danger from the range units. And they have a lot of range units in this level. You have 1 point higher accuracy on this one, so go for this one. Critical! For no reason. Nice job, Goozle.
He was going to one-shot it, right?
He had 21. That guy had 24 HP, I believe. So that he would have still doubled and killed him, but...
Right.
He saved himself getting hit with 3 HP by getting a critical.
He also saved himself a weapon usage.
Yes, so it had use.
Gotta keep that durability.
Uh-huh. So now I'm wondering... Loot needs healing, but she's not in danger right now, so it's not a priority.
Dazzle's probably going to get swarmed again.
Yeah, I wonder if there's
another spider coming up, too.
Yes, we're going to heal Dazzle again with Mulder, and then I'm going to rescue him with LaRachel. And LaRachel's not in danger from where she would be standing, so she'll be good.
It's only the mounted units that can rescue, correct?
Not true. All you have to do is have a unit with a higher con. That's this stat right here.
Constitution.
It's a stat they got rid of in Awakening. Rescue, I forget. No, rescue is not in that game, so that's why they got rid of it. Con determines more than just rescuing. It also determines how much weight the unit can lift. So it helps them wield heavier weapons without losing speed.
Ah.
But I think...
Because I was like, because when you said weight, I'm thinking, I don't remember there being a heavy weight in this game.
Oh, yeah. and Dazzle's going to miss all of... Oh, no, he hit once! Good job, Dazzle.
Yay, Dazzle.
You know what? That's actually really good, because they're not doing any damage to him. So he can wall them for as long as he wants, and then we can just slowly kill them.
I'm surprised... No, never mind, I'm not surprised anymore.
Ah, good! Thank you for missing.
Yeah, I was about to say I was surprised that they didn't move the spider up to hit Dazzle again, but
this is
now
why.
I see why.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, Seth is the weakest of my three good guys. Oh, okay. Well, they're not attacking Ford. They're just because.
Well, and that dog did less damage than the spider.
Yeah,
which is surprising.
The wolves are most equivalent, I would say, to a Myrmidon. They're really fast, but not necessarily that strong. Because each monster unit can be comparable to a regular unit, except the spider. I don't know what the spider is supposed to be. I feel like the spider is like its own unique thing.
Spider. What about Berserker? Because of how much damage they deal.
Oh, you know, maybe.
They don't, and they have got a bit of HP, but they didn't. They didn't take the hit that well.
I can see that. There is a large axe unit. That might be the equivalent of a warrior. I think that's actually the boss of this level. Let me go see him. He's a this guy. He's a cyclops. I guess he's could be more seen as the equivalent of a warrior. So okay, yeah. If we have to draw connections, and I would say that's pretty accurate.
In his overworld sprite, he's holding his axe like Garcia does. The ogre guy.
Oh yeah, he is. I don't have Garcia to make that comparison, but I know what you mean.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bring up wounds. I'm sorry.
It's all right. Can you kill this guy? No, but you can do some damage, and he won't do a thing to you. All right, or you can finish off the spider. But Seth can also finish off the spider. Right? Yes, he can. 100% chance, so do that.
I don't know, I think you should have killed the spider with fire.
With what?
Fire.
With fire?
You burn it. Kill it.
Oh, I guess...
Not a fan of spiders.
I guess I can kill...
That was just a personal vendetta.
Oh, I know what you mean. but Loot should actually kill this guy, because Dawes... I don't think Dawes is going to be able to, because he keeps missing. So, she can do that, and then... I gotta kill that archer, or Loot's gonna get killed.
Yes.
But I can still heal her with LaRachel. I'd rather not use LaRachel to heal, because I don't plan to use her in the long run, but... I'm desperate right now. If only you could drop someone and then the drop unit can move again, but no. Both the person who drops the unit and the drop unit are considered moved already once that happens. Yeah, go for this archer. That's the best move you got right now, Doozle. So. Because he won't do any damage to you! A lot of people... we're saying in the last episode where I completely got obliterated on the boat, that I should have just used Doozle, and he could have walled the entire thing. In retrospect, maybe he could have. Mm-hmm. The problem is I didn't think I was going to use him. I was using other units, so I didn't feel the need to use a unit that I didn't feel like I was going to use in the long run, but
right.
Who knows? And might as well just give it a try. Oh yeah, you did it!
Good job, Dazzler.
He did it. And then...
I'm proud of you.
Heal him, I guess. Will heal be enough, or should I use mend?
What's her magic stat?
7, so she'll heal 17 with heal. That'll be enough. Or I'll be off by 1. I might have done my math off by 1.
I didn't do the math.
Oh, we get it, yay. It was more of an estimated math. E-Frame, you can help now. Now, oh, you don't have your javelin anymore. I was going to have you javelin this guy. Actually, just stab him.
It to Seth.
Just stab him. Because I trust you to be out in the open and critical hit for literally no reason.
He needed it for style points.
Yeah, style points. Good job, E-Frame. You got some more style points. And I trust him being out now. Before, when I had him out, there was a bunch of axe units, but I trust him against the sword units.
I don't think they're going to go for him anyway, because, you know, Dazzle's got the axe.
Right. And then Tana, just move a little closer, and I guess that's all we're going to do for now.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, we're already in a better position than last time, because we actually cleared out this area of units. So, that's a good thing. Oh, I didn't heal Seth. But based on the damage they're doing, I don't think that's a problem.
Right. We just gotta try and get them to funnel in to the pier.
Right. They're all going to go for Seth. Oh, crap! Oh, my God!
That could have been bad.
That would have killed him if that hit.
I just. As soon as you said that, I was like, "Oh, that damage."
Yeah, that's a Zan battle. Baby. That's a sword that's good against horse units. It's like a horse slayer, but a sword.
Right.
I did not notice that.
That was scary. Please, wow. Seth. No, you've been the glue.
You've been the
that
glue
that holds our team together.
I don't know. He's pretty loose glue. I feel like Doozle's right. The more super glue here.
More like, okay, what about like paste?
Sure, paste. Alright. Other than that, we're doing okay. E-Frame, finish him off. I can't handle this. Just stab him.
Stab him in the face, E-Frame. Or the midsection.
Or look more like his abdomen, but whatever works.
Yes.
And then loot. You're healed. I don't remember you being healed. I thought you needed healing.
You healed her last time.
Okay.
Last turn.
Okay, you can go here. I trust you'll be fine being a ninja from the shaman because you're loot.
And then loot's OP.
Loot is really good. I think she. I think I've probably said it, but she has the highest magic growth rate of the whole game.
Yeah, I remember when you got her, you were talking about that.
Yes. I feel like one-shotting him. Good job. I probably didn't need to because he would attack twice, but I didn't want to waste my healing stabs.
I just noticed the Dazzle's animation for that. He just sort of taps him on the head.
I think it's like he's supposed to swing his axe so fast you don't see it.
Mm-hmm.
Or something like that. I don't know. No, she's not nature from the spider. And the shaman can only take loot. All right, we have a turn to just heal and stuff, except one of our healers is currently not usable. We're going to use this as the turn. We're just going to drop our healers down. So now next turn we can use them and do good things. Both Seth
I wish. And I wish Artur's robe wasn't all white with blue accents. I wish it was blue with white accents so I could tell that he wasn't a healer.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Because I keep thinking, oh, hey, there's a healer over there you can use. Oh, wait, that's Artur.
No, yeah, I usually identify healers by holding the staff, not necessarily their robe. But that's just me. I think that spot was safe. Yes, it is. Actually, I'd rather have Seth go one space forward, because forward can't do anything. Doosel, you can walk like 10 steps forward and be just fine.
Because he's Doosel.
Yes, he's Doosel. I probably am going to use Doosel in the long run. He's a perfect replacement for, say, Franz or Kyle.
Doosel's turning into my new favorite.
Oh, good. Yeah, I do like Doosel. I feel like he is overpowered early, meaning he'll suck up a lot of experience and possibly not be good later on, but... Because look, that's all the experience he's gained since I've gotten him. Because he came as a promoted unit level 8, and he's only gotten 27 experience during his whole time here. So...
I think you've only killed like one or two people with him. You've mostly been using him as a tank.
I guess that's true, yeah. Alright, so Doosel's gonna attack this spider. I don't think he's gonna kill it. Oh, yes, he will! Exactly will kill it, actually. Pointless critical.
Never pointless.
It's never pointless. It's just because they want to show off the animation.
Style points.
Yes. Spiders. Spiders.
So many spiders.
And Dazzle, just walk. Actually, no. You can probably kill this guy.
Or can he?
Yeah, just your regular axe. I don't care if you get hit. We can heal you.
We have the technology.
Yes. We are in the age of... I don't know, whatever age this is that the game takes place in.
I would assume medieval times.
Probably something like that.
Knights and kings and queens.
Yes. I probably didn't need to use mend right there, but I wanted to be sure. Like, yeah, I definitely did not need to use mend there, but... That's alright. Let's go here. LaRachel, does Doosel need healing? Yeah, might as well. LaRachel, you can go here. I don't care if you die. I don't think she'll die. I don't think there was any ranged unit over there that can hit her. But, yeah, maybe I will end up using LaRachel in the long run. Maybe I'll have to use 3 healers this whole game just to not die. I wouldn't be surprised at this point.
I think you might have mentioned this, but why do healers have a hit rating on their staffs?
Good question. It's probably coding, honestly, to be honest. Just like, it goes into the same room, per se, as an attack animation, so they have to give the action an accuracy, if that makes any sense at all.
The staff that you use far away, what's it called?
Physic. I always pronounce
it... Does that one go into the animation?
I don't know. Good question. Oh, I didn't heal Tana. Well, I used all 3 of my healers that turn, so it's not like I had a spare one. Alright.
All right, spiders.
Spiders! Spiders!
Kill it.
And we'll leave it with 1 HP.
Come on, Doozle, you're slacking.
That's fine. We can kill it with someone weak so they can get more experience.
Ross.
Yeah, Ross, look, you will let Ross do it. He can handle it. And the bright side, we do get a new recruit-like unit this level. Like a unit that starts off ridiculously weak but can do really well. That would be Ewan, who apparently is pronounced Ewan, according to the comments of last episode.
I will be the judge of that.
I think it is Ewan, because I think of the actor Ewan McGregor.
Right.
Unless he pronounces his own name wrong.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to think of it like that, I suppose.
Alright, who am I? Yeah, I can't. No one's in a good position to kill this guy. Except, like. Hey, Tana, if I let you kill it, will you not screw up? Actually, hey, Doozle, just stand here. Oh, I see exactly how I'm going to do this. It's really stupid, but it's totally how I'm going to do this. Now Tana can come in and use a Slim Lance. 99% chance.
And poke him in the face.
I would love it if she missed that. I would, like, love it in the sense that I would just like, lose all faith in everything, ever.
It'd be even better if she missed both hits. Just think of it like that.
She would have died the second that they would have hit her, though.
That is true.
Although, I guess it only had a 41% chance. Can the archers hit that middle slot? No, they cannot. That's the perfect spot to put Natasha and heal.
Natasha?
Yes, Natasha. She's becoming my favorite healer of my three. I thought I was going to like Mulder the best, because I tend to like him better in playthroughs. But no, I'm liking Natasha more. One of the other two can heal Tana. Or actually, no. LaRachel, you can't heal yourself, so Mulder heal LaRachel, and LaRachel will heal Tana. Strategy. And level for Mulder.
Yay, Boulder needs them levels.
He does, and that was a very good level up. Good job.
I thought it was good.
Yes. And something about the healers I'm thinking. I'm wondering if I should promote them early. It's not recommended. It's usually recommended wait till they're 20 before you can promote them. But I think
they're doing pretty good.
They take forever to level up is the problem.
Yeah.
But I don't know. It's just
unless you're just specifically going into like the world map, and letting your guys get hit just to heal them.
Right. I was actually considering doing that, to be honest. If I needed to heal the healers, that is.
Yeah.
Ow! 41% chance.
Why did that do so much?
I guess the spiders are really powerful. I guess I've never played on difficult mode before. Maybe I'm used to them being just regularly strong units, not super strong units. But yeah, and I feel like they do a straight 15 damage no matter what. Or no, Dazzle and Seth have the same defense, don't they? That's why.
I thought Seth had a little bit less defense.
I believe they both have 11 defense. It was Doozle that was the one that had higher.
Doozle has what, 14 defense?
I want to say 18. I could be wrong. 17, okay. And then Seth, 11. Dazzle, 11. Yes, they do have equal defense.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and they can both finish off the units that they did. Or we can do this in a fun way and get more experience for people, like Tana. The only one of this group that I know for sure I want to train up and use.
Mm-hmm.
Ford as well. I keep forgetting about Ford. He's way in the back, though. And he can't fly around like Tana, so he can't like get in a good position. What if I move the wall a little bit forward? Like, just make Seth stand there. And then Ford, you can go here and use your set won't kill him. Iron Lance will 93% chance. You can do that. Yay!
But Ford doesn't seem to be doing that much damage.
No. People. Of all the Cavaliers, Ford, I believe, is the weakest, but he has the highest speed and skill.
Mm-hmm.
So those are his strengths of all the Cavaliers in this game. And both Dazzle and Seth need healing, as usual. That is fine. I like this wall I'm doing. See, this is why I wanted all of them to go the same direction, because I could create a three-person wall, whereas last episode I only had a two-person wall, and there were holes all over it. So.
Well, your plan definitely worked well this time.
Yes, except for Ross.
Well, you see, you gotta have casualties sometime.
I guess I do.
Unfortunately.
It is unfortunate, but... Oh, wait! Oh, wait, Luke can take care of that spider. Never mind. I was like, maybe I should kill this spider before I do anything more. But no, Luke can one-turn him. Not one shot. It can take two shots, but she'll double, so...
It dies. It's gonna die. It doesn't matter how it dies.
Yes. Critical hit! Yay, she saved the use of her fire.
I was going to laugh when I lived with one HP.
Uh-huh.
And you just had to use the second use of fire.
Mm-hmm. Oh!
Best level up. 10 out of 10. Best one.
Oh, boy. Alright, is that space in danger yet? Yes. So Arthur can't go in the middle. That's fine. I don't mind Arthur at all, but I feel like I have enough magic units. Because once the healers promote, they'll be able to fight. But they're still...
They,
I guess their main use will still be healing.
What do they promote to?
Mulder promotes to either a sage or a bishop. And Natasha, I believe, is either a bishop or a Valkyrie. So if you don't know what those are, I mean, sage is upgraded mage.
The only thing I don't know is the bishop.
Bishop is upgraded monk, so light magic upgrade. Sages in this game actually can use both anima, which is a weird name, by the way, for a magic, anima and light. So sage is typically determined to be the better unit, but bishops, their skill in this game is to do double damage against monsters. And seeing there's a lot of levels in the game with monsters as the main enemy, so I feel like bishops can have a really good advantage. So honestly, I think I'm gonna do bishops for both Mulder and Natasha if they survive that long. LaRachel's two choices are Valkyrie and what's the other one? Mage Knight. They're basically either a horsed bishop or a horsed sage. Dussel. Oh, wait. Oh, these mages are going to attack from up there. Dussel, you stand here with your hand axe equipped. And Dazla? Hey, can someone attack that guy from a distance? Like, 8? Oh, that's not bad. That's not bad. Arthur, not as much as I wanted. You still need your javelin. Who is your javelin? Seth?
Ford.
Give me your javelin back. Get your Ford, take the javelin. And then E-frame. Get the javelin back. And attack with it. Yay! It only has 3 more uses after this, so we have to conserve it. Hopefully we can actually access the world map after this and buy more. But
there's always hope.
There is. All right, and then Dazla. I guess E-frame's gonna be the wall on this side. How many people would he be in danger from? Just this one. No one else can reach him, so he's fine. So Dazla, just stand where you are. Does anyone need healing? Seth and Ford can be healed of 1 HP. We should do it. Well, actually, no. Just Ford. Seth is 4 HP. It looks like. But just more experience for the healers. So yeah. These episodes get long.
Yeah, that's all right. I'm enjoying sitting here chatting with you.
Oh yeah, that's what I enjoy about the dual commentaries. A lot of people have complained about them.
Really?
More so of one person than the other that I've had so far. Mostly they just say it's like lame, it doesn't add anything. But I mean, and this was the thing I chose to give as a reward for patrons, so
right.
I don't mind it. I can understand what they're saying, but
I mean I'm enjoying myself and I was excited to be here.
Yes, I know. I hope this is living up to your expectations.
Oh, it definitely is, believe me.
Oh, good. But yes, that just wasted 2 uses of the javelin. So now it has 1 use, and a 1 use weapon is basically useless because it can't double.
It's not useless, it has 1 use.
It just it can't double though, so it can't really kill anything.
Well,
that's all.
Unless it's like a squirrel or something.
Yes, if a zombie squirrel from that gets summoned by Riav comes, we can handle it.
I don't know about a zombie squirrel. that's getting a little intense there.
Just a regular squirrel that's not even endangering us.
Just a regular squirrel.
A wild squirrel.
Well, I mean, they gotta eat sometime.
That'd be really interesting if there was, a hunger level. You have to kill wild creatures. That would suck. That would be like, that would suck.
there's an old RPG for the Genesis called Hydlide.
Oh, I know that game.
Super Hydlide.
Yep, I know that game.
Have you ever played it?
I've not played it, but I've seen a couple reviews on it.
It's, I played it. I don't own a Genesis, and I don't plan on buying one, so I use the dreaded emulator.
Oh.
The game is... it's awful.
Yep.
10 out of 10, do not recommend.
Yeah, that's what I undergot from the review I saw of it.
But when you mentioned hunger, it came into my mind, because their hunger mechanic is, if you don't eat at very specific times in the game, you will die immediately.
Just like, you just die just like that?
Yeah, you just drop dead. That's what I gathered.
That is terrible. It does sound absolutely terrible. Alright, how far can you move Dazzla? You can stand here. Is there any way you won't kill this guy? No. I was hoping Archer or Tana can finish this guy off. Oh wait, Tana can stand here. She can do, 16.
But she's gonna get hit though, isn't she?
Or 22, yeah, she'll get hit by someone else. Unless Dazzla can take that spot. That's why I was... Oh, wait, Doosla can take that spot. No, he can't. Oh, wait. They're in the way. Duh, I can't see because he's standing there. 6 movement. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, he can stand there. He can protect her. Now that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And Dazzla could have moved there, so I wasn't thinking clearly. Wait. You got an iron sword. You got an iron lance. Killer bow!
That's dangerous.
Okay, I gotta watch out for that. And Tana would be in danger of that. Good thing I saw that. Oh, wait, we need to send someone up here to get Ewan and the arena. But I guess I should take care of these enemies first. And then once everyone's out of the way, except for the boss, then that's when I abuse the arena.
You could send Ephraim over
there. Just Ephraim?
I mean, I don't know how good he is against those guys. But.
I don't know. I'm thinking I should just... Well, I don't know what I should do.
Maybe Ephraim and the Rachel or something.
Ephraim's already in danger from this killer bow guy. If Ephraim dies, I'm going to be really upset.
I would also be upset. Believe me.
All right, well, Dazzla, you're the best of this group to be up front. Actually, Doosla would
and
be, so
Doosla
go in front of him. So Doosla could probably reach this mercenary over here. That guy's a killing edge. I'm glad I noticed that. Don't attack him. Just stand there and block him. Doozle can survive a couple attacks. I should have healed Doozle before I made him do it. We'll go over there. Darn it. Oh, well, we can still heal other people. Heal Ephraim and Seth.
There needs to be an undo button.
Sorry, what's that?
There needs to be an undo button.
Undo button? Yeah, I feel like there was in a different Fire Emblem game, but I think I'm thinking of a different game.
Maybe.
Well, I can understand why you can't undo something if you, like, attack someone, but just if you move someone without doing anything, I feel like you should be able to undo.
Yeah.
But I guess I can see why you shouldn't do that.
It means you need to plan better. Maybe mess something up.
Mm-hmm. And I don't think anyone else can move forward, because they'd all be... Oh, no, Ford can move one space. And then LaRachel, stand here. You can't staff anybody. You can staff loot. Nah, save that 1 HP for someone else I actually care about leveling up. No one else can go up. More people are in danger of this killer bow than I would like, but... Yeah, I feel they're going to go for Ephraim. Of these 3 people that are in danger, I feel they're going to go for Ephraim, so... Someone will have to take care of that. He is holding his... he's not holding his javelin. Never mind. Tana can move one space. There. They're not starting off with the killer bow. Darn it. Actually, they might go for Dazzla, now that I'm looking at this. Because they just started with attacking him. I feel like a critical hit can kill him, just based on how much he has and how much... Well, no. It's hard to say. Oh, yeah, zero. Good call going for Doozle there. I think that's all he could go for, though.
Yeah, he couldn't reach Dazzle.
Yeah. Good job. And then that guy. He may get a critical. Yep, critical hit will do 6 damage. Miss. Great.
Crits do what? Triple?
Triple, or yes.
Triple damage? All right.
Yeah, Doozle is not going to move from that spot. They're going for Dazzle. 6. No critical.
Why do they do triple damage? That seems out of the ordinary.
I don't know. That's what they've always done it. Oh, I didn't see that guy could reach us. Yeah, a critical hit plus this flux, I think, would have been enough to kill Dazzle.
Yeah.
But, oh wait, no. He would only do 6 damage. That would have only been 18. No, that wouldn't have been enough. It'd be close, but not quite. I'm worried about that mercenary with the killing edge. Although, as long as Doozle doesn't move, he's quarantined. just Doozle's gonna have to fight other people to help let this group progress. Actually, Tana, can you help? Ah! I was hoping you'd one-shot this guy. I don't want you to get hurt, because then I'll have to heal you. Archer, can you finish him off? No. Ford? You don't have a javelin. Should I risk putting Tana there? No, I don't think I should.
Because the archer's right there.
Yeah. But I plan to kill him with Dazzle.
Mm-hmm.
I'm worried about the shaman's finishing off afterwards. I guess she has good resistance. It ain't worth it.
If you don't, what you could do is you could have Archer move up one space, weaken the guy, have a Tatana kill it, then move Doozle up, not Doozle, Dazzle up, kill the Archer.
Maybe.
So both Tana and Archer get experience.
I don't know. I feel like that's more trouble than it's worth. I'm just gonna throw the javelin. Make my one use be an actual good one use.
Mm-hmm.
And now it broke. Alright, Dazzle, kill this guy, please. You cannot kill this guy. That is very disappointing. Can Loot reach that spot? Oh, Loot can stand right here in front of him and not get attacked in retaliation. That is perfect, Loot. Good job. Oh, that was good. I didn't even think of that, but that was really good that I had Loot there in range. Now I just have to make sure Dazzle is protecting her. But at the same time, the shamans aren't going to do much to her, because she's magic.
Right.
I think you need your battle axe for this. Try to one-shot these people. Go for this one. Critical! Didn't need that.
But...
unless you were going to miss. One thing I always wonder, in terms of how it calculates how critical hits are, does it first calculate whether it hits in the first place, or does it just do the... critical hit calculation first, and if the critical hit calculation adds up, it just automatically hits.
I feel like it would calculate the miss chance first.
I would
So it wouldn't have to do extra calculations about the crit chance.
I would think so, but I just wonder how the RNG is, because apparently someone told me that, I guess I didn't really understand it fully, but for how it calculates whether an attack hits... it generates a random number between, I think, 0 to 99, and the average is... It generates two numbers. Either it's 1 to 100 or 0 to 99, either 100 different possibilities, but it does two numbers, and the average of the two numbers decides whether or not it hits. If that number is equal or lower than their hit chance, it hits. So they were saying, based on that fact, the hit chance is not accurate, because... Doozle might be in trouble. Oh, wait, no, he's not. Even if this guy gets a critical, he's fine. So Doozle just stand there. Should I attack him? No.
Was this a person, like, in a comment, or...
yes,
someone you were talking to?
It was a comment, and I looked it up, and I was looking into it. I didn't quite understand it personally. I'm sure there is math behind it, and I'm sure they're not wrong, necessarily.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just... weird to think that way, that it's not the exact chance. Like, a 57% chance is actually more like a 61% chance or something like that. And something lower than 50 is actually even lower than it says.
Yeah, I mean, the non-accurate numbers like that are not usually a precedent in Fire Emblem.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, it reminds me of Pokemon Conquest.
Oh, yeah.
With the non-accurate damage.
Yeah.
I worked third shift, so I put your videos on in the background.
Okay.
And I ended up, during that entire playthrough, yelling at the video the entire time, why are you not killing him? You've had enough damage.
Yeah. And I would put a healer here, but they might... Oh, actually, it's just a shaman. The healers have good resistance. Who should maul or heal? Dazzla, Loot, Tana are the options. Oh, wait, Tana's right there? I guess it's just a shaman. I didn't think of that when I put her there, did I? But, yeah, the shaman's the only one who can attack us this turn. So, I think we're fine. Yeah, just heal Dazzla. Okay.
This is going way better than I thought it was going to go.
Oh, you didn't have faith in me?
No, not that. I just, this level seems a little unforgiving in terms of the enemy placement.
Oh, it's nothing compared to the ship level. But yes, it is difficult. Okay, first time that guy did not get a critical hit. And Dusel has not hit out of the three times he's swung his axe.
Well, you do have the minus, like the triangle thing.
Yeah. Okay, only 8, even if it hits. Luna is a really weird spell. I believe it has 0 attack damage. Let me look at it. Yeah, it has 0 attack damage, but it negates the enemy's resistance entirely. So the base damage you do is literally your magic stat every time.
So 8.
So he will do 8 damage no matter what.
Mm.
It also depends on the enemy's resistance, of course, but... Oh, wait, no! It ignores resistance. So, yeah, he will literally do 8 damage no matter what. So it's a very weird spell. It's good for certain situations, like...
Are their stats, you know, the same as your stats, or are they...
What do you mean?
Like, let's say that mage right there, you just killed a dark mage, whatever it is.
Yeah.
Does he have similar stats to Loot if she was a dark mage?
Good question. Let me go look at her. Loot can't be a dark mage. There's only 2 characters that could potentially be dark in this game.
I was just using her as an example.
Yep, I know what you mean.
Her magic stat's 16.
Yeah, she's the highest magic of the game, so it makes sense. Yeah. Speaking of Loot, can you take care of this guy? No, you can't! Oh! What if it was both Archer and Loot? I don't necessarily want Archer to go here. 8? That leaves him with 19. Perfect! Absolutely perfect. Archer, you finish him off, just in case I decide to use you.
Right.
Oh, that is perfect, because Dusel was having a hard time over there.
Is Archer a priest?
He's a monk. That's
monk.
Yeah, in
they
this...
use light magic?
Yeah, this is the last game that had this system, actually. But magic was in, Anima, Light, and Dark were the 3 magic classes. In Path of Radiance is the game, they changed it to Fire, Wind, and Lightning, or Thunder. Mm-hmm. And there's usually a 4th magic they throw in the game to be an other. Whereas Awakening, I believe, has Dark as well. Yeah, Awakening is Dark. Whereas Path of Radiance, I believe, had Light as its 4th obscure magic.
Mm-hmm.
And Archer's not in danger. I think we're good. I think we're doing really well. So Dalza, move a space. Move a... just 1 space forward. I don't want to rush into this. Move a space forward. Dusel, move it up here. And then Natasha can't reach him, darn it. Mulder, you use a mend on him.
I didn't realize how low Dusel got. Wow.
Yeah, because he got critted twice. That's impressive, if you think about it.
Especially by an enemy. Wow. So this level's almost over.
Well, unless I arena grind.
Well,
wondering if I'll show that. If I decide to arena grind, if I'll show that in the actual episode.
Mm-hmm.
Or speed it up or something. I don't know yet. The episode's already over an hour long. But that's typical for this series. And I'm thinking the next... who can I heal? Oh, Lute. Yeah, heal Lute. Why not?
Yeah, Fire Emblem does take long time. Long time to play.
Some people were suggesting I should split up the long episodes into shorter ones, but I feel like I would rather concise it into one chapter. Just
It wouldn't flow as well.
It wouldn't. It's the same. And like one thing I was worried about, like let's say I cut it at when I was at a half hour of this episode, but then I end up dying later on in the chapter. That would mean the first half of this chapter was completely worthless watching.
Right.
That's just my logic, at least. I can definitely understand why someone would disagree, though. And Marissa, I need you in to recruit her. I believe. I think, yeah. Thinking about it, I think he's the only one who can recruit her. Or maybe Ephraim? Maybe Ephraim can. I don't know.
What is she? What kind of unit
is
that?
She's a Myrmidon, exactly like Joshua. So, she'd be the perfect replacement for him if I wanted a replacement for him. Like, and I believe they have almost exactly the same stats.
Forgive me, I don't know who yet. I don't know who Joshua is.
Oh, he was
earlier. I think I missed that.
He was earlier in the game. I used him so sparingly, but yeah. Myrmidon, let's see, in Awakening, that would be Lunku.
Oh, him. Oh, man.
you like him?
I loved him.
Yeah, he's pretty good.
You know how he can't talk to women, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So in my first playthrough, I found Olivia.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, ooh, she's an interesting character. She can't talk to anybody. let's make Long Q can't talk to women and Olivia, who can't talk to anybody, get married.
Yeah, I think I've seen that combination before.
And then they had a son.
It was Inigo, yeah.
Yeah, I loved it. And then Inigo is the perfect complement to the trio.
Yeah. Can anyone be healed of 1 HP?
I'm not going to spoil it, a game that's, 2 years old, but, you know.
I don't know. I feel like you can spoil Awakening if you want. I don't know what you're hinting at, to be honest, so I would like to know.
his personality.
Oh, yes.
Being the womanizer.
Yes. I think the perfect combination, at least for Inigo, to make sense, would be Virion and Olivia, because Virion is also like a womanizer type character. So I feel like that would inherit traits from both of them, if that makes sense.
Yeah. Never mind. I was looking at that wrong.
What? Oh,
yeah, I saw the zombie's HP bar, and normally when you attack things, your guys are on the right side. So I thought you attacked the zombie and you had Seth had all that HP.
Oh, okay.
That was my brain just deciding to mess up.
Oh, no, that's fine. But yeah, that was an Entombed or Entombed. I don't know how you're supposed to pronounce that, but yeah, they're really strong for some reason. They decided to make them very strong, but they give a lot of experience. Marissa, please don't walk forward. You know, I didn't even think of that, if Marissa walks forward on her own. I'm hoping she only attacks if we get in her attack range.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really hoping that's the case, or else Dewsoul is going to have to survive some critical hits and not attack her in return.
Were you about to call it her danger zone?
Her danger zone? Okay, she didn't walk forward, so... Okay. Well, I don't know, I feel like that's not an inaccurate word. Tada! Are you in danger from anyone? No! Assuming we kill this guy, you'll be fine if you attack from this side. It's perfect for you to kill. He'll do a crap ton of damage to you, but he will not kill you. Use a Slim Lance, because that has higher accuracy.
Miss.
Ah! That's fine. We can heal you. Did she stab before the zombie finished walking over the left? I feel like she did.
No, she was in a hurry.
He's like, hurry up! Stab him.
Don't have all day.
Uh-huh. And yeah. Alright, yeah, Tana's pretty good. I do she starts off at a ridiculous low level, though. That's the turnoff about her, but I feel like she makes up for it because she has really decent level ups, for the most part.
So far, from what I've seen, they've been pretty decent.
Mm-hmm. Yay! Good job, Ford. See, we're kind of training Ford and Tana a little bit. Kinda. A little.
I'm getting to like Ford.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't dislike him at all. It's just Kylo was doing so much better, so I opted for him instead of...
Yeah.
Alright, looks like no matter who I decide to put in danger of Marissa, they will also be in danger from this axe guy. But I need Ewan first. Let's start sending a couple people over there to recruit Ewan. Let's get Ephraim and someone else just to cover him. Mulder. Just in case he needs a healer. Natash, you go heal Tana real quick. And then...
Where did we get Mulder? Mulder.
It was in between the chapter we got Gilliam and Franz and chapter we got Garcia and Ross. We got them in like a cutscene.
Where in the story land?
I believe that's in between chapters 1 and 2.
Mm-hmm. So really in the way early.
Very early on. Yes. Mulder's the first healer you get, and you get him very early, so... And I can put someone right here without any danger. But what was Seth's HP? Oh, he has pretty low HP. Lorangel should heal him.
I feel like Mulder's been around the longest.
Yes, of all our healers, yes, he has.
I mean, I'm talking about everybody. I don't consider Seth
to be
viable. I don't consider Seth.
Well, technically,
he's guide tier.
Oh, yeah, I know. Seth and Irika are the first units you get, and then you get Gilliam and Franz are the first two you get.
But unfortunately, they couldn't be here with us today.
They're not here anymore. So, yeah. So, of the units I am using right now, Mulder has been around the longest, unless you count Seth. But we can't because we didn't actually start using him until now.
Yeah. He only now just became useful.
Yes. They didn't move at all. These guys only move when we're in danger. Except the boss doesn't look like he moves in the slightest because we are in danger of him. So that is good that he does not move in the slightest.
Well, I guess we could just wait for Ephraim to kill the other dudes.
Mm-hmm. Maybe. I hope not. All right, this space right here, we can draw in that skeleton that's up there. I'm going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all I'm going to do, actually, over here. Tana can be healed one more time. And Doozle can be healed a little bit. So let's do that, just to get some more experience for people. Because... it makes sense to me.
I mean, experience is useful.
Yep. Move out of the way, loot. And then LaRachel, go here. Yeah, I might as well train up LaRachel just in case I end up using her. Because knowing my luck, one of my two healers will die.
No, don't say that. You're going to jinx yourself.
Oh, I don't know. What are their movement range? They have equal movement range. 5 and 5. Good. So they can walk together. Is he now in danger from a mage? No, he's not. That mage is in a weird spot. Alright, and everyone else, I don't think I want to move at all. No. Wait, is that spot? That's not spot. That spot's not in danger, is it? No, move Tana right here. Oh, Tana got a guiding ring. Must have missed that. She got a guiding ring. That's really helpful.
Mm-hmm.
That can promote any of our healers or magic people. I feel like the guiding ring promotes more units than anything else. Because it literally promotes every single magic unit of the game.
Hmm.
Whereas some items, like the Ocean Seal, only promotes pirates and thieves. And there's only two of those in the whole game. One thief, and Ross could potentially be a pirate. So those are the only choices to use the Ocean Seal on in this game. But anyway.
So.
I don't think there's a way I can draw out this mage without...
Can you reach the mage from where you're standing?
No. Who has high resistance? 8-4. Mulder, you draw him out. Might sound stupid, but...
Be the bait, Mulder. You can do it.
Yes, Mulder, be bait. Isn't that sad? I'm using my healer as bait? It sounds horrible, but it's gonna work.
It's efficient.
And everyone else, do nothing, I guess. Just everyone cuddle together, just in case we get some support boosts. Because in the older games before Awakening, I feel like Awakening did a really good job with the support system. In this game, to gain a point in support, you just move the unit next to the other unit. And then they slowly build up the possibility of having a conversation. And I'm really glad I did not have Ephraim in danger of that elf fire. I did not notice he had elf fire.
That would have been bad.
Just so I know, how much is he gonna do to hit? 14. Ah, two of those wouldn't have killed him. But...
You gotta... Is this one of the levels where you have to kill everybody, or is it just defeat the boss?
Oh, for the mission of this chapter?
Yeah, the goal.
Good question. I'm gonna check on that. It is... I get the Elfire. Cool. Defeat boss. So I don't necessarily have to kill these guys, but I kind of want to.
Too bad Mulder can't heal himself.
No. If the other guy had an Elfire and didn't even do half, I think he'll be fine to de-endanger again. That might be a big assumption, but I don't know. I feel like that's logical. Unless the Shaman somehow has like 10 times higher attack power, but that'd be really weird. And everyone else just stand next to each other. I have no idea if these guys are compatible with each other for supports, but we're gonna try it anyway.
You never know.
I already had this whole system I had in mind for who was gonna pair up with whom for my original cast, but all of them died, so now I have no idea who's gonna pair up with whom. Not that it helps all that much in this game. It's a lot more useful in Awakening.
It's nice for story purposes.
Yeah. Kill him in one stab! Yay! Now I don't have to heal you again. Okay, now that those guys are out of the way, I feel like Evim can take care of the skeleton himself. Ooh, a toxin lance! I did not notice that. That's not gonna do much damage, but I'll get poisoned.
That's not good.
It's fine. It'll be fine, Ephraim.
Does poison hurt you on the field?
Yes, it hurts you a little bit every turn for 5 turns. Unless you use a restore staff to heal it.
Or an antidote.
Yes. I think in this game it's antitoxin. But yes, I knew what you meant.
Yeah.
Oh, this is probably really boring right now because I'm not doing anything. But if I move any space forward, Marissa will come forward and we won't be able to recruit her because she'll just kill. Yeah. And she may kill someone because she's really strong.
So you gotta understand, we're not trying to waste time, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes. Trying to think. I'm probably gonna use Dusel to draw them out. I'm wondering if I should unequip Dusel's weapon though, just to make sure he doesn't kill her. But I don't think she. I don't think he will, because she's really evasive.
Mm-hmm.
That's my logic, at least. Hey, Mulder, you need healing. Stand next to Natasha and have her heal you.
So, with these two new characters, Ewan, what is he? Is he,
He's a pupil, is his trainer class, wow. unit class, it's like Ross, except he can promote into a mage afterwards.
Pupil Ewan would like to battle.
My name is Ewan McGregor. I'm training to become a Jedi. I need to find the woman named Leia. I know I'm screwing this up, but that's fine. It's okay. Ewan. Ewan. Yeah. Oh, we killed the dragon shield. Cool. Someone can increase their defense by 2. Okay. He starts off incredibly sucky. Like, incredibly
zero
sucky.
Zero defense,
yeah. He incredibly, ridiculously sucky.
If anyone looks at him the wrong way, he will die.
Yes. The other thing is, he only has 4 movements, so there's no way he can walk to Marissa to talk to her. We have to draw her out. He's probably been too weak to go to the arena, to be honest. So... But yeah, he can throw into either a regular mage or a shaman. He's one of only 2 units in the game that can be a dark mage shaman. The other one, is a dark mage shaman. He just is that unit. Much later.
Do you have plans on what he's going to be?
At the moment, I don't have plans to use Ewan. but if I did, I'd probably just go regular mage. I'm not a fan of the dark mages in this game, to be honest. In fact, not usually in general, am I? There's nothing wrong with them. I just feel like regular mages are better. They're more well-rounded. And have better use. Dark mages, on the other hand, are like axe users of the physical world. They're a lot stronger, but less accurate.
Right.
So, whereas, I don't know. Alright, well, why am I making Ephraim go to the arena? Oh, I wasn't.
You
I was
have
making
access
him
to the arena.
I was making him
yeah,
just
you
kill
had him
guy.
Kill the skeleton guy.
Yes, I was making him kill the skeleton guy. While we're here, what's in this shop? Not that we need a shop in the middle of a battle, but fire, lightning, shine, restore, just basic stuff. Nothing real, all that special. Okay.
I liked that shop too.
Or I don't plan to use Ephraim in the arena. He's pretty good as it is, and once he reaches level 20, we can't even use him anymore for a while anyway, so. Okay. I think the turn after next, we can get Marissa. Or at least send Doozle to draw them out.
At least attempt to.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I think it'll be this turn, because can Ephraim... I mean, yes, he can move right there. So Doozle, the question is, should I unequip his weapons?
I trust Doozle to live.
Oh, I know he'll live. So yeah.
But I don't trust him to not kill everything else in his path.
Right. So Ewan, because
he's just that good.
Oh no! Don't give him more weapons. Take his weapons.
Give him more killing power.
Yes. All right. Oh, that's all I'm doing this turn. Everyone else, just stand where you are and try to love each other. I don't even know if you guys are capable of loving each other. Or who's compatible with whom, because I didn't even plan for you guys. So hopefully something happens. There's Marissa! She won't do a single damage to him.
Not even a singular damage.
No. She is pretty weak, though, so it's understandable.
See, that's funny because about, what, 10 minutes ago when you were saying, oh, we gotta get her, but... You're saying, oh, she's super strong. She
okay,
can one-shot
okay,
anybody.
Okay. She's strong in the sense she has a sham shear, which is basically, I don't know why it's even in the game. It's basically a killing edge that has even higher percent of a critical hit, but lower base power. So take your weapons back and attack this guy, please. Thank you. And then Ewan will recruit Marissa, and Marissa will go attack that other guy. I think he's an archer. I believe Ewan has... Watch me be wrong about Ewan being the one who has to use her to recruit her. No, talk. Okay, good. Thank you. There you are, Marissa! Ewan, what are you doing here? Marissa, the Mr. Oh, I missed that line. They send you here. They assigned you to fight under General Garrick, right? That's right. But the chief's not here. I know, it's all a mistake. Your commander's over there working on another job. He wants you to join him. Really? He said that? Yep. I'm on my way. Hey, wait, take me with you. The group's headed east too. Let's stick with them for now. Very well. All right. As you guys will find out as we're playing through, there is this other group that we're slowly recruiting members of. It's a mercenary guild run by a guy named Garrick, who is the leader, and we'll get him eventually too. Marissa, Ewan, Saleh, who we saw talking to him at the beginning of this chapter, and I believe someone else. Tethys, a dancer we'll get later, are all
this
members
of
his mercenary
units.
Guild. What's that?
This game has a lot of units.
It does, but it's good it does because,
Well, you needed
dying.
Them. You needed them.
Yes. Dalsa, you draw this archer, please. And now that we're done with that, we can actually start going back to the arena. Ford! And Tana! Oh, wait, support! Who can you support with Ephraim? Do I want to do that? Hold on. Do you have any? You doing any supports right now? Does Ephraim have any supports right now? No. I guess Ephraim and Ford can support. I don't know if they can be there. I don't know if I want them to be the A rank, but they can do. They can some do some support. Sure. Let's see. I've never done theirs before.
They're best friends.
Hey, Ford. Yes. Oh, what is it, Prince Ephraim? What are you hiding? What are you talking about? We are in the middle of battle, you know. Pay less attention to me and more to our enemies. No, Ford, give it up. Come on, let me see it. Fine. Oh, he's like a parent. What is that? Is that a painting? No, it's a topographic map. For strategy, we need to plot out our strategy, don't we? During battle, I have to look at this map and analyze enemy lines. But it's clearly a landscape painting. Did you paint this? Yes, a long time ago. This is impressive, Ford. You're both good with a sword and a brush. Just make sure not to mix up the two. When Eric and I were young, we'd sneak out for long horse rides. We used to watch the sunset sitting behind the wings where we were to our hours. Your painting reminded me of those days. Prince Ephraim. But during a battle probably isn't the right time to indulge your hobby. What if something happened to you? I don't know if Woolburn's here. I always stay alert in the battlefield. I'll cut down my enemy with my paintbrush. I mean sword. Good luck! Heh, you're all talk. Interesting, so Ford likes painting. I never knew that. I never knew that about him. Interesting. Okay, Loot, I don't think Loot needs any time in the arena. She's fine. So Loot, stay over here. What can she do to the boss, just so I know? Actually, I don't even want to touch the boss until we're ready to kill him. And we are not ready to kill him at the moment, because we need to do training in the arena. So, okay.
I'm not sure what I was expecting Ford to have behind his back.
Yeah, I was like, what could it possibly be?
Like, Ford, what could you possibly have behind your back that would be a wow moment for me?
Yeah. All right, LaRangel, you stay over here and heal the people who I don't think are going to be in danger. Should I do Archer, too? Why not? You never know who's going to live and who's going to die, so you might as well train him up, too. And Seth, you just stand here, because we don't need experience for you either. Oh, should Marissa and Ewan go? I think Ewan will definitely die in the arena, so probably not him. But Marissa, maybe. What is Marissa... A level 5? Yeah, she needs training too, if I plan to use her. Should I use her? She's a Myrmidon. So... She can be good. But she also has some weak points.
She has potential.
First of all, can you kill this guy on your own? No. Yeah, she needs training. Loot, you take care of this guy for me. I can always trust Loot to take care of people.
Yes. Loot is too good.
Oh my god, and Pointless Cradle, just show off. Wow. And oh my god, this is a long episode. I think I'm definitely going to cut out the arena parts.
That makes sense.
Alright, I'm kind of getting sick of this. Yeah, I'm getting sick of this. Screw it. We're doing Tower of Volney.
That's fair.
Start with Loot. Fire times 2 does more, because you actually attack twice. And I got to keep in mind... His up-close weapon is a sword slayer. So, if I attack up-close with a sword, he will attack back with the sword slayer and will probably kill that unit. So don't attack with a sword unit, is what I'm trying to say to myself.
He has a lot of HP. Wow.
Yeah, Cyclops has a lot of HP. That's why I think they're more equivalent to a warrior, because warriors have a lot of HP.
Mm-hmm.
Dazzla, what can you do? 8, and you'll do 12 to you, so we're good. Chance of critical, though. 1% chance of critical, but I've definitely seen the computer get a hit criticals with 1% chance before.
Oh yeah,
so,
oh yeah.
You know, Seth is actually not bad because he has a lance right now. Except, that's a lot of damage. Never mind. I think we're just gonna leave it as it is. And Luke didn't get hit, so I don't need to heal her. I was gonna heal her with LaRachel, but I don't need to. So, just you guys stand next to each other some more. End it here. Yeah, people watching this who play Fire Emblem a lot, the older games specifically that have arenas. How do you do it? How is arena abuse a thing when half the time they can't beat the unit that they fight against? Or maybe I'm using too low-leveled units in the arena? Maybe it's only for units that are a little stronger? Like, for example, let's throw, you know, give it one more try. Let's throw Tana in there just to see what happens.
Was the arena last time this bad? When you did
what
it,
do you mean?
When you did it previously, in one of the episodes before, like with Joshua.
I didn't do any off screen.
No, you didn't.
In previous playthroughs, I've tried the arena before. Oh, you're good against this. That you're fine. In previous playthroughs, maybe it's because I wasn't on difficult mode. Is that it? Does difficult mode increase the power of the arena units?
Does it increase the power of just all units in general?
Maybe. So that might include arena units. Who knows? Alright, well, I've grown one level with Tana. That's all I've gotten so far.
We did it.
And I think I have a net loss of my money, to be honest. And Ford, he was at level 9 before. He grew some experience.
Mm-hmm.
And Marissa, I think, killed one thing. And then she ran away from two things. So, yeah.
Doesn't seem like this is going to be much of an option.
Yeah. Alright, so we killed this Cyclops and we're finally done with this really stupid chapter that's taken way longer than it should have.
Yeah.
And then we can actually record
it
Soul
took...
Silver. Critical hit for no reason. Thank you, Loot.
I feel like it took an accurate amount of time for the strategy you were using. I'm not saying it was a bad strategy. Because you were just trying to wall them out, stall them, make them come to you.
Nice level up, Loot. Yeah, I agree. I had to take it slow.
Because, I mean, we saw what happened last time.
Mm-hmm. Alright, we only lost Ross. That is a shame, but we have two axe units already, so... Alright, Emmy Truth and Blue Defeater, we're taking care of the wounded now. You mean, Ross? He died. Never mind. Pledge of Sire as the truth, ran every soldier. Anyone who breaks these laws will be severely punished. By whom? Who's here to enforce the laws here? Prepare defenses along the east in case of assault. The capital's not far and fresh troops will be here at any time. Good point. Set up three rotating watches. And there's Myrrh.
Is she a dragon?
Yeah, she's a manakeet. Like Noe from Awakening.
Oh, I love Noe and her companion, Gregor.
I don't know. I was never a fan of Noe for some reason. She never was strong for me. Everyone tells me she was really good for them, but never was for me for some reason.
All of the animal people were super good in my playthroughs. Like Noe and the Tagwell.
Pan?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Pan was really good for me. She always, every time, no matter who she was fighting, got a double attack.
I have had better experience with Pan than Noe, but I'm not too big a fan of her, to be honest, just because there's not much, he's not ready to divorce himself from his compassion? Is that a translation error, or did people in medieval times really talk like that?
I mean, technically you can use that as it literally means, you know, a separation.
Yeah, I guess it does. I just feel like that was a poor choice of words. I don't know if that's maybe how medieval people actually talked, but I don't know.
I have no idea.
And I forgot what I was talking about before I did that. Oh yeah, Pan. Yeah. I like her. She's good, but there's not much customization to do with her. It's either make her a Tagwell or, well, everything else she can be is stuff anyone else could fill.
Yeah.
You know? That's all.
But how old is Rickon?
Very young. I think he's the youngest character in Awakening. I don't know
Is he an actual adult, though?
I don't know. He can marry adults.
Because Rickon can have children.
Yes. This sounds wrong. My first playthrough, I had Rickon with Pan.
I also had Rickon with Pan.
Oh, nice. All right, well, that's the end of this episode. I don't want to stall it any longer. We'll continue with some Soul Silver. I don't know what's going to go up first on my channels, but hope to see you guys there. Do you have any last words?
Hello, and goodbye, everybody.
Hello and goodbye. All right. Well, see you all later. And, of course,
rock on.